I think Sol is in a bit of rush. He wants to go to bed. But thank you guys for tuning into A Freaker World. It's a best of seven. It's a Terran versus Terran. The winner of this will take the crown for A Freaker World for their country. Will it be France? Or will it be Poland? And representing Poland, spawning down the bottom right-hand side, it is Sol, the first A Freaker World champion. Wants to retake his crown. Now going to have to do it versus somewhat of a monster who beat Snoot 3-2. It is Clem. Playing for Team Exceed, Sol for Team OSC Esports, so should be a bit of a good match here. Now, Clem, interestingly enough, going for the slightly later gas. I'm not sure what the decision on that is. I mean, I don't have much else to talk about this early in a TVT. But the map is a Biogenesis, so it's a bit of one. It's one of the more crazy ones. Now, I personally have wanted to see these two guys play for a long time, because Sol, he's a player who beats the very best. He beats the very best on ladder now and again, but he doesn't quite have that consistency. And Clem is a player who's looking pretty consistent and really rising. So I'm wondering what happens when these two butt heads, and I'm curious to see. I wanted to know for a long time who is almost the better Terran player. I don't like to phrase it like that, but yeah, which one of them will take this tournament? Now, Sol looks like he's going to be going for a Reaper Expand, whereas Clem is going to be going for a more tech-heavy build, going to be going for a Factory. Now, it's a Biogenesis. It's a bit odd. You look at it and you think, are we ever going to have a normal game on this map? Whereas, you know, from time to time, we do have quite a few normal games on this map. And that's the reason, because, I mean, once the players sort of get their natural established, the third base, yes, the opponents are very close, but it's possible to take a third base and whatnot. And so the question really is Clem going to put on the aggression so hard? Whereas Sol, he realizes that maybe I just want to play a macro game on this map. Now, the Reaper's on the way for Clem, and he's making a second. And this is a little worrisome for Sol, because Sol looks like he's going to be going right into maybe Reactor Cyclone or Hellion. Whereas he's just gone for a single Marina. Now, multiple Reapers versus one Marine, I don't know if you've ever mathed that out, but generally the one Marine loses. Now, the question is, how bold is Sol is Clem with this Reaper? Is he going to dive it right on in? He's seeing that there's no expansion, so he's actually turning his Reaper around. Now, that's a bit unfortunate for him, as no Reaper for Sol has arrived in his base just yet. Clem's starting his own command center on the low ground, by the way, but he could have gotten a bit of damage, but there was always the risk of, is something going to be hitting me? He's playing it safe instead. And as a result, Sol sort of gets away with his greedy opening here. He's going to have a lot of Cyclones on the way. Now, Clem just with the single Cyclone production, but we could be having a lot of Cyclones made in this game. Clem's got the two Reapers. But Sol doubling his Cyclone production here. He really may want to put on the aggression. And the thing is, Clem hasn't identified this, that Sol, when that Reaper, well, he hasn't seen a Reaper just yet, but it's hard to know. We'll have to see. These two Reapers are moving out. We'll see if they run into these Cyclones right now. CC's floating over for Sol. Clem's is going to be just finishing up just a second later. So these two guys taking a bit of a different path. Sol's was a bit more economic, really. This Marine's gonna go down. These Reapers may actually make it into the main base. Looks like Clem gonna get one SCV so far. Now this one Cyclone is in position, though, to work away on these Reapers. One grenade will go down. We'll see if these Reapers can escape. He gets another SCV, so far getting two SCVs. I'm not sure if these Reapers will escape. One of them's running by. Now the two Cyclones for Clem actually put the pressure on the front there. So one of the Reapers gets away, and four SCVs fell there. So that's pretty decent for Clem putting some aggression on when he's really down on Cyclones, but he is down on Cyclones. He needs to run with these units, as Sol has five currently, whereas Clem currently just has two. Or pardon me, Sol has four. He's about to be at six. I mean, I know Cyclone versus Cyclone TVT can sometimes just feel like a math game. Who's got more? Looks like Clem gonna be going for another factory. Now he's got a command center on the way already, so looks like he's gonna be going into the macro. Now he hasn't started another reactor, so he's likely gonna get up a siege tank soon here. This Reaper is putting the pressure on Sol. One Cyclone is forced to turn around. That's nice. That's something that Clem doesn't have to worry about. So it's gonna be four Cyclones. Two more are about to pop for Clem. We'll see about his unit positioning, though. That one Cyclone's a little far forward right now. There's five Cyclones here. They're going to clash right now. SCVs are pulled. So far, one Cyclone has gone down for Clem. Some SCVs have fallen as well, but looks like that Sol will be shown the door, but this Reaper's actually causing carnage in the main base of Sol. SCVs are falling, so what could have been a nice little advantage there is sort of slipping away a little bit. And this Reaper's going to get out once again, being such a nuisance. May actually be able to get that Cyclone. Oh, that one's so weak. Oh, but it doesn't. How much health did they... Yeah, I believe that Reaper could have killed that Cyclone if he shot it. I mean, that is some very fast thinking he'd have to have done there. I would have been blown away if Colin did that. But this is a TVT, and it's really looking like it could be a long one here. As, I mean, a best of seven can go the distance. We're seeing double armory coming out of Clem. He's making siege tanks and more Cyclones. Sol, though, on his side, is just making more Cyclones. I mean, the first game did not... this is a big mistake from Sol. Every Terran has done that at one point. SCVs rallied, but not mining. There's a siege tank out now out for Clem, but Sol may just try and break the front here. That one siege tank is going to fire, but Sol's actually just going to go for it. The siege tank's taking a few good shots. SCVs are pulled for Clem, and it looks like the fight may just go his way. It's hard to call. It's four Cyclones, but a few more are popping out right now. And so it seems that Clem may have managed to just push back his opponent right now. And he's going to have upgrades on his side. He's going to have more production. So these guys... relatively equal right now, except Clem squeezed in this third base, so they're equal on workers, but army-wise and production-wise, Clem is ahead. And I say production-wise because he's heading into siege tanks. Not just the Cyclones like Sol's been doing. 1-1 will make a big difference when it does come down to the Cyclone versus Cyclone. Three Cyclones moving down for Sol, possibly going to try and snipe off some of these units here. However, if they got caught, that's a pretty big loss there. Command center may be forced to lift here. Siege tank's in position. Looks like Clem is going to intercept right now. However, he's taken a bit of the poor end of these Cyclone trades. The siege tank would need to unsiege here. Fight's going down. Clem's actually sort of fighting at a deficit there. It's hard to say. Good micro from Clem, though, is keeping these Cyclones alive, and he takes a positive trade there. Sol starting his own third base on location here. Siege tanks, Hellions on the way for Clem, wants to get some run-bys perhaps. This fight's continuing on. Cyclones have been trading. How many Cyclones have died for each side? It's currently 15-9, so Clem has traded a lot more efficiently. He's ahead on workers right now. He's got the faster base too. He's got the faster upgrades. And when it comes down to Cyclone versus Cyclone, the upgrades will make all the difference in the world for Clem here. This siege tank gets picked off there. Cyclone does go down in the process. So these Hellions may even be able to finish off one of those other Cyclones, and they will. And now Clem trying to pursue, but does have to retreat. If Clem just started amassing his own Cyclones, he could probably just go kill Sol now that he has the 1-1 upgrades. But he's playing it very passively. He's getting up a fourth base already. Hellion run-by's on the move. He doesn't have Infernal Pre-Igniter just yet, but he'll still be able to pick off a good chunk of SCVs. Cyclones for Sol are going in. He's just committing more and more to this. Now there's the upgrades on these siege tanks already, so they're dealing a lot of damage. However, Sol, Cyclones in smaller numbers can trade versus this. He's getting in, but both players are going to start losing SCVs. But as more production comes out for Clem, he will deal with this. Whereas at the third base of Sol, there's not much to clean this up. Even at the natural, there's just one Cyclone. So upgrade-wise, Sol's really going to be... I mean, Clem, pardon me, is going to be really getting ahead as he's heading into his plus two. Now working away on more SCVs. So Sol's economy has taken a real beating. He's in a very tough spot in this TVT. Now, it can sometimes be tough to close it out, but it's looking like quite a good spot for Clem. More Hellions moving across the map for Clem. One of them gets a little caught there. But these SCVs will be vulnerable. Sol moving out once again, but with all these siege tanks, I don't know what he'll be able to get done. Hellion's hitting the natural once again. Sol's not going to be too happy about that. Instead, he's going to try and continuously push. A Cyclone's coming down to deal with this, but Clem good micro getting as much value out of these as he can. 9 more SCVs going down, so Clem really has a massive lead right now. The siege tank is in position, it's going to shell away, but not doing too much damage there. There is the 2 siege tanks, and there's a massive upgrade advantage for Clem right now, and for Cyclone versus Cyclone, that makes all the difference. GG gets called. Clem takes the game just by playing so solid, and Soul's going to have to fight hard to come back versus Clem, I think. But thank you guys for tuning on in. We've got possibly 6 more games to go. Alrighty. Okay, apparently there might have been a patch pushed while we were playing or something, so apparently we got to re-log here. I don't know much about that, but we shall see. But that was a good game played by Clem. I mean, that's how we've seen a lot of TVTs go on a Biogenesis, but Soul sort of just almost beating his head against a wall with those Cyclones trying to make it happen, but it just never did. So we'll just have a second of downtime here, then we'll get into the next game. Alright, so we try and keep downtime to a minimum at Afrika World, and as a result, we're jumping into the next match. Thank you once again to everyone for tuning in. This is the grand finals. The winner here will be invited into the next Afrika World and possibly start a long reign. The longest current reign has been a laser. But looking at the way this series goes, I felt that this would be the way. The guy who's probably going to be proxying Reapers here, it is Soul. And his opponent spawning up in the top left-hand side of the map, it is Clem, the Frenchman. So Soul, a guy who does like his proxy Reaper. Now, this isn't the best map for it, but it can always get a win. So we'll see what Clem does to try and defend this. If he goes for the double gas, that's generally what'll set you up better. Clem gonna put his barracks in the back. I'm not sure how this is gonna affect it. You know, so close to the barracks of Soul here. I also like how if you select their vision, you can see if they have the APM counter on. So it is going to be the double ghast for Clem, but really he isn't scouting, so knowing that this is coming is really the most important bit. If he moves out with his Reaper like he did in the last game, it could simply just be a quick GG. Also, forgive me for not adjusting the score. Clem is currently up 1-0. Soul looking to take a quick one to bring it back. Now what is Clem going to do? Start a factory immediately, I assume. And there we go. First Reaper on the way for Soul. Second one will be started relatively soon. And that's where the, that's the question here. Will Clem's Reaper meet an unfortunate end if it runs into Souls? Or will he be able to keep it alive? all that Clem really needs to do is buy time till he gets out a Cyclone or a Hellion or two, and then he'll be fine. Sol, we'll see if he's just thinking, I'll transition to this, or if he'll really commit. Reaper's moving out for Clem. This is the big question. He's going to see the Reaper there already for Sol, and he actually runs by. That's pretty big. He needs to retreat there. Clem's going to know this is Proxy Reaper. He throws a grenade, but that might have been a bit too much if he loses his Reaper here. And he does. That is absolutely huge. A second Reaper is coming out for Clem, but he's forced to pull SCVs already versus these Reapers of Sol. Two SCVs have gone down so far. Clem doing his best to micro, but the third has already fallen, soon to be the fourth. Although he does micro well. His own Reaper's about to pop out, but that is going to get chased down. A Hellion pops out as well. That's going to help too, but Hellions are very weak. Reapers have their bonus versus light. Five SCVs have fallen so far, but it seems that Clem may have just held. Sol continuously making Reapers may commit more to this. A Marine pops out. That's going to add extra DPS. With the high ground advantage, Clem may just be able to hold on, but he's taking a bit of damage here. Sol continuously making these Reapers. Back at home, though, he's already producing a Cyclone. He's transitioning. He knows that he's not going to be able to brute force his way in with this. Terran players have evolved so much, in which they know, I can't just win with this. I'm going to have to do something else. Sol floating over a barracks, going to use that high ground. Clem trying to pick off any Reaper that he can. He's got the Hellion in his own Reaper, so it's certainly possible. Five Reapers in total. It's quite a scary number. Clem starting his own command center on location. Almost loses his Hellion there. Keeps it alive, though. The dance continues. Hellion gonna get repaired there. Clem moving out a little bit bold. These Reapers could sneak in. He's really trying to play the mind games to catch these. Cyclone is out on the map already for Sol. Clem has another one that has popped out, so we will have that. But looking at this, this is Sol trying to go for a quick move right now. Clem needs to react. He gets bounced by those grenades there. The fight's going to go down. Really, it's going to come down to the Cyclone versus Cyclone, but these Reapers are significant support here. Good save by Clem, keeping his Reaper alive. Trades it for one of... well, trades a bit of health for one of Sol's. Sol's trying to put the pressure on. He starts his own command center back at home. He even dropped a mule there. Okay, that's a bit questionable. A long-distance mining mule isn't something that you want. So Sol, a little bit supply blocked right now. He's continuing on with the pressure, trying to poke, but there's three Cyclones out for Clem. This barracks is a bit of a nuisance here. Sol's using it for the vision. Supply-wise, they're relatively even. Worker-wise, they're very close. Clem will have a slight income lead. Cyclones are going to try and burn down this barracks. Sol may use it as a chance to try and get in and get an SCV. Clem's actually, yeah, he's chasing this, so he will lose an SCV or two to this. Well done by Sol for predicting that, but this will be the end of the Reapers here. Two SCVs have gone down. Three in total. Oh my, look at this. Sol wants to steal this add-on. Is he going to steal it? Oh no, he didn't get a chance, but imagine, he could have landed it and stolen that add-on. That would have been very cute. Banshee coming in for Sol. He's not been slacking back at home. Turrets are on the way at both bases for Clem. He's got a good number of Cyclones. Factory will be delayed here. There is enough energy for a scan, though. Clem trying to keep these units alive. These Cyclones are taking a poor path, though, so... Sol's Banshee gonna try and pick off this SCV, so he's finding good damage in this game. Clem maybe going to try and put the counter pressure on. He's got a very good Cyclone count, whereas Sol has been going into his siege tank and bio. He may be caught off guard right now, though. Five Cyclones in total, but there is going to be a siege tank and a bunker, so in theory, Sol should be able to hold this. And with that, Sol's going to be in a decent spot, I think. Banshee does fly straight into a turret. That's unfortunate. And it does go down. Good placement by Clem. Clem, though, not going to be able to break this spot. Forcing SCVs off the line is nice, but he's losing more and more units here. So Clem is not in a great situation. Sol's teching. He's going to be going into bio play here. He scans. He wants to break this, but he cannot. There's simply no way that he can break charge into those Cyclones. If he had a Raven, perhaps? Well, I mean, that's a big if. But yeah, I don't see that happening. Another Banshee on the way for Soul. He's gotten good value with him so far, so why stop? So I'm not sure what Kun should do. Maybe throw up a third base? Third base that is natural, maybe? It's hard to say, because he's got an odd amount of production. He doesn't have any upgrades on the way. But he can't break his opponent. And soon enough, Soul's going to dance around him with Bio, so I think Soul's found himself in quite a good situation in this game. I'm trying to sort of math out what he should do. Infernal Pre-Igniter is cute. Mass Hellion, perhaps. Combat Shield on the way for Soul. Give me 1 second here. Hellion's moving out on the way for Clem, but the third base for Soul is just landing. I feel like I didn't mention the third either. This Banshee may be scouted. So Banshee's moving in. There's no third base on the way for Clem just yet. Maybe he's gonna go for a bit of a siege tank Viking push or something. Just try and go for... I guess that's sort of what he has to do. He's starting his third command center on location, but... And I think he just shot his own Cyclone by mistake. With this Banshee, Clem's in a poor situation. These Banshees have been worth their weight in gold for Soul here. I mean, yeah, for Soul. They have not been worth their weight in gold for Clem. Double Medivacs on the way. I can only assume that that's going to be in order to drop Hellbats, and that's one way that Clem could come back on this. Dropping Hellbats will really force the tanks to friendly fire. And if he hits a timing before the 1-1, that would be very significant. Third base is now just being resumed built. And I think with this is going to be Clem going for it. Go for broke, eh? He's down on supply, though, but this is a very strong mech army here. These medivacs, these hellbats, they have a lot of health. They can change the fight rapidly, and if he catches Soul out on the map, that would be huge. Okay, is he going to be able to bait Soul into this? I think he is. Soul's seeded up on the low ground, but the Hellbats are going to drop in. Oh, but such a smart move by Soul. He disables the drop. That's not going to happen. Siege tank sieges up for Clem, but Soul just has too much, and with that, I think he's going to take the game and tie up the series. Clem going to retreat, but Soul has a lot of bio here. I don't think there's too much for Clem. He doesn't have much production. He's down on supply by a large margin. And with that, I think Soul... Gonna tie up the series, if I have to say. I mean, that was so smart by Soul, disabling those medivacs, preventing those hellbats. Whenever you think StarCraft has been figured out, there's always another layer added on. That was just so smart. I did not expect that. I don't think Clem expected that, and I don't even know if Soul expected to do that. He just thought and said, yeah, let's disable those. Command Center gonna go down. Hellbats gonna drop on top of this army. Last minute attempt, but there's just too much. GG should be momentarily. There we are. Clem gonna tie out. Soul ties it up with a proxy Reaper into just solid Banshee play. We'll find out what the next map is. These guys are tied up, so this is more like a best of five. Thanks to everyone for tuning into A Freaker World. Find out what the next map is. I mean, it's a mirror matchup. We are actually going to have a short break, and then we'll get right back to it. Thanks for watching, guys. Alrighty, so we're getting on into it. The next match. Whoever takes this will take the lead in the series. It's best of seven. Currently tied 1-1. Let me do the little floppy. There we go. I'm getting the hang of this observing thing. It's been a while. I feel like the 2 weeks between most of Eureka Worlds is enough for me to forget. Either way, tied up the series with a Proxy Reaper in the last match. We'll see if he's going to be able to bring it back or take the lead. And then there's Clem. Played very solid in the first match. Ultimately fell. Soul just sort of picked him apart in that last game. That was sort of the most we've seen Clem fall apart, dare I say, today. I was curious as to who was going to be the better of these two players, and I mean, I don't like to say the better of the two players, but whoever takes this tournament will make a strong case for themselves. Forgive me as I follow that SCV and have a glass of water.